Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're doing something exciting. We're doing the April Fairy Loot, I think this is. Or maybe this is March, I'm not sure. But this is really late for obvious reasons. And I'm pretty sure a lot of people have unboxed this already. But I'm really excited. I usually love Fairy Loot, and I for one have not looked at any spoilers, I don't think. So I'm really excited. I do think I know what the book is, so I'm not gonna wave my scissor around. Let's just put that down there. But yeah, I know what the book is, but some of the items I'm not sure about. It has like little strings falling out of it. So let's, oh, it's like packed to the brim. Let's get into it. Well, first thing I see is a postcard from Velaris. I'm pretty sure that's a court of, which is the first one? Akatar, a court of thorns and roses. I think I've read the first two, but it was a while ago and I never finished and I don't plan on it. But it's a really cute postcard with a really sweet note on the back from the team. It's so jam-packed. I'm trying to get things out without dropping like the bits. Let's do this tiny one. Oh, this is cute. We have a little headband. It's got a little squashed, but I only use headbands when I'm putting my makeup on because my head is a weird shape. But this is cute, I think. Let me cut this strap off. It has crows on it, so it has to be either the Raven Cycle or Six of Crows, I'm assuming. I can't find the spoiler card, so we'll see. Let's see how it looks. I mean, yeah, my head is kind of a weird shape, but we'll keep it on for now. Okay. Oh my god, I'm so excited for this. Okay, we have a tumbler. Fairy Loot and Holly Black tumbler, which is so cool because we just found out that there's going to be a garden novella. I'm not like obsessively in love with the Cruel Prince trilogy, but I do really enjoy it. And I would love to see Cardin's point of view. I'm not really sure if it's his point of view of all three books or if it's his point of view as a prequel. If you do know, let me know. This is so pretty. What is up with people writing male point of views of books that we've already read? Midnight Sun is the other obvious example, but we did know Midnight Sun was coming out for a while. This is such a cute tumbler. I do drink water exclusively out of straws. Just because I need to force myself to drink water in the first place, I'm not very good at doing it. And when I have to actually open a bottle and like drink water, it's just too much work for me. Don't judge me, okay? But this is really cute. This is, I think the last lines of Queen of Air and Darkness. It's to family in fairyland and pizza and stories and new beginnings. Scheming great schemes. I can toast to that by Holly Black. I love this. I like how it's transparent. I don't really have a tumbler that's transparent. I like it. Found the card. The theme for the month is Break the Curse, which I didn't know. Yeah, the headband is the Raven Boys, which I don't really get, except for the crows. I don't really get why there are flowers in there, but we're gonna go with it. I actually like how it looks. This was done by Tara Ja. I think she does the cards as well. And the Queen of Nothing tumbler cup was designed by Novaran Tail. She's done quite a few designs. I really like her artwork. Moving right along, we have a passport holder which says Citizens of Wonderland, which I'm assuming is Alice in Wonderland. It's inspired by Heartless by Marissa Meyer, which is a retelling of Alice in Wonderland. So that's cool. I'm probably not gonna use it because I don't use passport holders, but it's a really nice idea. Next, we have a notepad, which is very Aladdin themed, which is Break the Curse, makes sense. I love the little illustrations. Usually I make notes on my phone because I'm guaranteed to lose a piece of paper, but this is cute. I can use it as a to-do list. Genie Notepad by Katarina Book Designs. Oh, book sleeve, yay. We have a book sleeve. It says, failure isn't absolute. Just because you couldn't save everyone doesn't mean you didn't save someone, by Bridget Kemmerer. I'm guessing this is a court, no, a curse so dark and lonely. I promise you guys I'm not that tired. But yeah, let's see. Purse Breaker book sleeve designed by Evie Bookish. I really like it. I do have a lot of book sleeves, nowhere to go to use them, sadly, but always appreciated. And finally, other than the book, we have a lanyard, which is Caraval inspired. I recently unhauled my copy of Caraval. I just posted that video, so I will link it if you want to know why. I don't own a lanyard just because I don't have enough things to put on a lanyard, but now I own one, so that's cool. And before we get into the book, we have two of the tarot cards as usual, but we have two couples this time. I think these are both from Throne of Glass. I'm pretty sure this is Irene and Kale, and Lysandra and Adolin? Not Adolin. Oh my god, what's his name? I hated him anyway, so who cares? And finally, let's get into the book, which I already knew, but I also saw on the spoiler card. So let's look at the art first, because there's always art. Oh, that's pretty. I love redheads. That's really cute. And on the back, there's obviously a letter from the author. There's the fairy scoop. And next month's theme is memories, which I'm excited for. Oh my god, the edges sparkle. That's so cute. The book is Bone Crier's Moon by Catherine Purdy. I don't know if you can see, if I can focus enough, but the edges sparkle, which I think is so beautiful. I'm not the biggest fan of sprayed edges just because I feel like I use a lot of tabs and just I feel like I ruin the look anyway. This is a book I'm really interested in. It is signed. I really like how there's like a book plate that's part of the end pages that she signed, and there is an illustration on the back. I feel like because Fairy Loot's editions are so beautiful, even if I don't like the book, I'm probably gonna keep them. Just because they're collector's items at this point, and I just really like them. I've not had the best track record with reading YA debuts. I don't think this is a debut, but like new YA books. I've just not liked any of them. I don't understand why, but hopefully this will break that curse. Did you see what I did there? But overall, I think my favorite item, I'm actually really digging this headband. I like the cuff. I love useful items. Obviously, I also love the... It's so soft and padded. I just really appreciate that. It was a really good quality. So yeah, I really like this as well. And I'm really excited for the book as well. I don't know too much about it, but I'm pretty sure the main character is part of an organization or is a... entity called a Bone Crier, and she has to kill her true love to get her powers or something like that, but obviously she's gonna fall in love with her true love because that's how YA works. I am really excited, and we will see how I feel. Hopefully I'll read it soon. I do know my library has an audiobook, so maybe I'll go that route. But yeah, that is this video. I don't do a lot of unboxings, but Fairy Loot is one of my favorites, and I really did want to unbox this on camera, so let me know if you enjoyed it. All of my links are down below, as well as the subscribe button. If you did enjoy it, I would love it if you subscribed. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye!